The Mekong countries, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, and Vietnam, have witnessed significant modernization and economic development since the 1990s. Unfortunately, this development has excluded many smallholder farmers and ethnic minorities. Large land concessions and land leases were approved for foreign and national companies to invest in order to boost economic development. In this process, millions of farmers lost part or all of their land and forests. Farmers, often ethnic minorities, have been and still are involuntarily displaced, losing their livelihood without adequate compensation. The Mekong Region Land Governance Project was initiated by the Swiss government with co-financing from Germany and Luxembourg. It was launched in early 2014 to ensure a better recognition of smallholder land rights and access to natural resources in Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, and Vietnam. The project has supported numerous development initiatives in the four countries through a network of 80 partners from civil society, research, and government agencies who are reaching out to smallholder farmers. Approximately half of Myanmar's territory is occupied by ethnic groups who manage their land and forests according to their custom. However, these customary practices are neither recognised nor protected under the current legal framework. This is exposing communities to high risks of land grabbing. In the last two decades, at least 2.1 million hectares of land was allocated to commercial, industrial, and agricultural investors. In most cases, no consideration was given to the people living in these areas. This has sparked significant unrest and confrontation. MRLG partners who represent various ethnic groups decided to make a concerted effort to accelerate the recognition of customary tenure. They developed a participatory approach to document customary tenure with villagers.
Customary tenure guidebook. ယုံကြည်ပါတယ်အဲ့
တော့ကျွန်တော်တို့တိုင်းပြည်မှာတိုင်းသားအမြောက်အများနေထိုင်ကြတာဖြစ်တယ်အဲ့ဒီတိုင်းသားလူမျိုးစုအားလုံးကိုလွှမ်းခြုံနိုင်ဖို့ကတဝူးတယောက်တည်းတစ်ဖွဲ့တည်းဆောင်ရွက်လို့မရဘူးဒါကြောင့်မို့လို့အဖွဲ့အစည်းပေါင်းစုံကနေပြီးတော့စုပေါင်းပြီးဆောင်ရွက်မှသာလျှင်ဒီဒလိထုံးနှံမြေယာပိုင်ဆိုင်မှုနဲ့ပတ်သက်လို့မှန်ကန်တဲ့ကောင်းမွန်တဲ့အပြည့်စုံတဲ့ထောက်ထားတွေအချက်လက်တွေကဥပဒေထဲမှာထည့်သွင်းရေးဆွဲနိုင်မှာဖြစ်တယ်ဒါကြောင့်မလို့စုပေါင်းအားဟာအများကြီးအရေးကြီးပါတယ
်ဒီလိုမှမလောက်ထားဘူးဆိုလို့ရှင်တဲ့အကာအကွယ်အတိမတတ်မှရမှာမလောက်ထားဘူးဆိုရှင်အကာအကွယ်တွေကမရှိဘူးလေနောက်လို့နောက်သားဆိုတာလည်းမလောက်ထားဘူးဆိုရှင်ဘယ်နေရာဘယ်သူဘယ်ဝဘယ်ဘယ်ဟာဆိုတာမသိတဲ့အတွက်အကြောင်းလို့မတတ်မှရဆိုဘယ်နေရာဘယ်လို့ဆိုတာမတန်းနဲ့မရတာပြုစုထားပေးဖို့လိုတယ်
Since 2000, the government of Laos encouraged large-scale land acquisitions through land leases and concession investments in hydropower, agriculture, and the extractive resource sector. Due to rising land disputes and complaints, the government reacted in 2012 by imposing a moratorium on new concessions, in particular the agroforestry ones.The agroforestry companies already operating in Laos before the moratorium are finding new solutions to develop plantations in negotiation with communities. Some companies involved in tree plantations are improving their community consultation process with the help of local civil society organisations and MRLG. They developed various tools to facilitate greater community participation in decision making.This provides communities with a better understanding of the company's agroforestry model, the contracts proposed, and its benefits and potential impacts on the villages.
The good thing is that the people who are interested in the world are very easy. From the people who are interested in the world, they can see the world and the foster world. They can see the world and the world. They can see
the world and the world. They can see the world and the world. They can see the world and the world.เป็นโจเฮลเบิร์ตตะเวียกเหมือนกันป่าตึงวีในเบิร์นป้องทืนบ้านช่วยเหลือแบบนําประปาเนี่ยสะดวกเงี้ยวีนเบิร์นบ่ยึดกนอกมาบริษัทกนอกตะบนเบิร์นลุ่นนี่มีไหนดี
มันมีความสําคัญหลายเนาะในการเฮ็ดสัญญาร่วมกับชุมชนเพราะว่ามันสามารถเป็นอันหลักฐานอ้างอิงเพื่อป้องกันบ่ให้เกิดข้อขัดแย้งในอนาคต
In Vietnam, hills and mountainous areas are densely populated with estimates of up to 25 million forest-dependent people. After independence, most forest land was allocated to state forest companies. As a result, ethnic communities lost access to natural resources on which they depend. They remain today the poorest portion of the population.
Trước đây thì cái đất lâm trường...quản lý nó cũng lỏng lẻo dân thập phương đến chặt gỗ lấy làm củi bán
Since 2003 the policy changed the government started to reallocate forest land from the state companies to farmers and communities however ethnic communities have not been able to regain access to their customary lands that they used to manage collectivelyIn 2015, the revision process of the forest law started. Civil society organisations took this opportunity to advocate for better recognition of customary rights in forests. With the support of MRLG, a coalition of state and non-state actors was formed, opening a dialogue with the Vietnam Forest Administration and the National Assembly on drafting a new forest law.
Trong thời gian qua, thì Liên minh đã dừngvới sự hỗ trợ của MRLG thì chúng tôi đã được nhận cái dự án để đóng góp vận động chính sách cho luật bảo vệ phát triển rừng sửa đổi 2017. Họ đã chúng tôi cũng đồng thời huy động họ tham gia vào các cái cuộc hội nghị hội thảo đóng góp ý kiến cho cái quá trình xây dựng chính sách của Quốc hội.
Tổng cục Lâm nghiệp và ngành Lâm nghiệp đã được nhận được sự hỗ trợ rất nhiều từ các tổ chức phi chính phủ và các cái tổ chức cá nhân và các chuyên gia các cái chuyên gia lâm nghiệp. Tuy nhiên là để luật mà có thể thực hiện một cách hiệu quả thiết thực thì chúng tôi cũng rất cần sự tham gia đóng góp của các tổ chức xã hội dân sự đặc biệt là của Foreland trong việc triển khai các cái nội dung liên quan đến cái thực hiện quyền nghĩa vụ của chủ rừng là cộng đồng dân cư và của các đồng bào dân tộc thiểu số miền núi.
The new forest law was accepted in November 2017 and contains various articles which strengthen the recognition of ethnic communities' customary rights in forests. It gives priority to their forest reallocation.
Việc thứ nhất đó là đã góp phần là đưa kiến nghị và đã được chấp nhận vào luật là luật tục truyền thống của người dân tộc miền núi đã được ghi nhận vào luật. Các cộng đồng dân tộc thiểu số được công nhận như là một chủ rừng và họ được giao cái quyền sử dụng rừng và đất lâu dài đối với các cái khoảnh rừng mà họ đã bảo vệ từ trước đến nay. Đó là vấn đề quan trọng nhất.
Ôn nhân trần ta duẩn không ai uom đào nhận nhân trần hăng ôn đảng nhà nước mà hăng chia áo uom đào bún y bùa để bùa hăng chính mẹ áo uom đào để điều nhân cho hộp uy toàn uy xí á.
Trước đây gia đình tôi còn chưa được cấp đất thì chúng tôi khó khăn vì không có đất sản xuất, nhưng mà bây giờ lâm trường cũng đã cấp đất cho chúng tôi thì mong từ giờ trở đi chúng tôi cũng có đất làm và thay đổi kinh tế gia đình hơn để đỡ khó khăn hơn trước này.
Trong tương lai thì cái số đất này trả lại còn ít quá, bây giờ dân thì cũng càng ngày càng phát triển, cũng muốn nhà nước tác động với lâm trường làm nào để cho giả thêm để cho dân chúng tôi, không những gia đình tôi mà cả khu vực này được thêm cái đất để mới có thể đảm bảo được cuộc sống.
Secure tenure and access to land play a central role in the livelihoods of smallholder farmers in the Mekong region, but also worldwide. With the expanding interests of private and public investors into agricultural land and water resources, it is even becoming more important to address the issue and to provide the necessary measures for secure land tenure. This is exactly what the MRLG project is doing.
Within a short period of time, the project has created an essential level of awareness and raised up constructive dialogue among stakeholders in the region. This is only expected to grow with the next four-year phase that commences in July 2018.